Today on Ask Us Anything, we're going to do something just a little bit different. What does this ship have in common with this Navy frigate and this German U-boat and this woman?
Figured it out yet? Well, it's Rae Montague. She's the girl who faced racism and sexism in the segregated South. She's the girl who was forced to ride in the back of the bus. She's the girl who was told she would never be an engineer because she was a woman. She's a girl who was denied entry to a college engineering program because she was black. She's the woman who proved everyone wrong. She's the black woman who became an internationally registered professional engineer. She created the first computer-generated ship design, the Oliver Hazard Perry class frigate. The war hero our ship is named after. She's the woman who shattered the glass ceiling at the Navy when she became the first female program manager of ships. She's the woman who briefed the Joint Chiefs of Staff every month. She's the woman who taught at the United States Naval Academy in Annapolis, Maryland. She's the woman who earned the civilian equivalent of the rank of captain. She's the black woman who we named the OHPRI STEAM program after. Let's take a deeper look into her story. Rae was born in Little Rock, Arkansas on January 21st, 1935. She grew up in Arkansas in the racially fraught 1950s, during a time when Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on a bus to a white man in Montgomery, Alabama, and the governor of Arkansas called up the National Guard to bar 9 black students from an all-white Little Rock Central High School. In 1942, during World War II, 7-year-old Rae Montague had the opportunity to view a traveling exhibit of a German U-boat that had been captured off the coast of South Carolina. She was immediately excited.
Let me go up the little ladder and down the hatch. And I looked at all the dials and the mechanisms and looked through the periscope and I said, wow, what do you have to know to do this?
His response? Oh, you'd have to be an engineer, but you don't have to worry about that. The clear implication was that a black girl could never become an engineer, let alone have anything to do with such a vessel.
Well, I didn't realize I'd been insulted. So I went home and I told my mother and she said, Rae, you'll have 3 strikes against you. You're female, you're black, at that time the terminology was Negro, and you have a Southern segregated school education.
Rae Montague graduated from Merrill High School in Pine Bluff, Arkansas in 1952. Rae had hoped to study engineering at the University of Arkansas in Fayetteville, but at that time, the school did not award engineering degrees to African-American students. So Montague graduated in 1956 with a degree in business. Still determined to become an engineer, she headed to Washington and secured a job with the Navy as a clerk.
Even though I had a college degree, they started me at the bottom of the ladder as a clerk typist, GS3.
She worked her way up.
For some reason, all the engineers called in sick. And since I'm the first person on the computer, I went out and mounted my little tape, and I stood there and I waited, and nobody came out to operate for me. And I walked over to the console, and slowly but surely, I started to flip switches and do type-ins, and the tapes took off. And I kept working, and they went back and told my boss. And he came out and he said, Rae, I didn't know you knew how to operate the computer. I said, I don't. He said, well, what are you doing? I said, I know how to do enough to get my job done. He said, fine, from now on, this is your job.
Becoming a digital computer systems operator and a computer systems analyst at the old David Taylor Model Basin, now the Navy Surface Warfare Center in Maryland.
I worked with guys who had graduated from Yale and Harvard with engineering degrees and people who had worked on the Manhattan Project developing the atom bomb.
In the 1970s, during the height of the Vietnam War, Montague's supervisor gave her 6 months to create the first successful computer program for ship design. A daunting task. The department had been trying unsuccessfully to accomplish this for years. She quickly realized she would need to completely tear down and rewrite the computer code, which would require working day and night. Word of the program reached the president, Richard Nixon, who asked to see the plans for a computer design warship quickly.
President Nixon was in office. And it normally takes 2 years to do a rough draft of a ship. He gave the Navy 2 months instead of 2 years. The admirals came and they gave me 1 month. I brought that rascal in 18 hours and 26 minutes.
The Oliver Hazard Perry class U.S. Navy frigate. The Oliver Hazard Perry class was a class of guided missile frigates, named after the U.S. Commodore Oliver Hazard Perry, the hero of the naval battle of Lake Erie, and of course, our namesake. For the feat, she received the Navy's Meritorious Civilian Service Award in 1972. Ms. Montague shattered the glass ceiling at the Navy when she became the first female program director at the Navy Sea Systems Command, NAVSEA, and was the division head for the Computer-Aided Design and Computer-Aided Manufacturing program. Her achievement put her on the map. Her last Navy project was the nuclear-powered Seawolf submarine. Ms. Montague was one of a number of black women who started in the 1930s performing invaluable high technical work for the United States government, but who, working behind the scenes, were invisible to the public, and often even to their colleagues. She was the U.S. Navy's Hidden Figures ship designer. At the height of her career, she was even briefing the Joint Chiefs of Staff every month and teaching at the United States Naval Academy in Annapolis, Maryland. Her message was always the same.
You can be or do anything you want to be.
She was inducted into the Arkansas Black Hall of Fame in 2013 and the Arkansas Women's Hall of Fame in 2018.
Don't forget to like and subscribe for more fun videos from the Oliver Hazard Perry.